the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world. You can beat the war. You can talk the guy.
Hello, everyone. Today is Tuesday, September 3rd, 2013. And welcome to an all-new edition of Live with Matt here. All-new season. This is our first video blog of the new season. You saw our little introduction there. Thank you to Bill Mayoris for creating that for us. It was like a little arrow going through the city and then eventually stopping at Live with Matt. So it was great. Thank you, Bill, for doing that for me. Also, you might have seen a little collage that I put together of all of our co-hosts over the last year that we took a look back last week on our final video blog of the season. So it was great to see that again, as well as some of our little introduction there. All new technology here. We've now converted to the MacBook Pro, so we're using iMovie now doing our video blogs. No co-host next to me, but you see here I have our Live with Matt Video Blog Award. This is our Video Blog Award show. This is our first video blog of the new season. This was your opportunity to vote for your favorite co-host, your funniest segment on Live with Matt, and your favorite segment that we had here on Live with Matt. So you voted over the summer. We did our little summer flashback, so it's great to be back here. We're back to school already. I can't believe it. The summer flew by. But you got to see some of our look back over the previous year. And some of our new viewers, this was your first opportunity to see some of those clips. Our video clips for the first season are going to remain on YouTube, so you can always go back and take a look at that again. A lot of things here going on. Next week, we're going to have a co-host joining back once again. We're going to get our kickoff right here with another co-host sitting next to me. Hopefully, you'll enjoy our new season. I'm looking forward to our next year here on Live with Matt. It was a joke, you know, and it turned out to be something that everybody wanted to see. So I'm very happy about that, and I'm happy to do this here for you each Tuesday. Brings a little entertainment, of course, to YouTube. I want to first start with our first segment, and our first award that we're going to give out here is for our funniest moment on Live with Matt. So here it is, our funniest moment on Live with Matt.
Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah.
Hello.
Hey, I'm calling all those pizzerias. Look, we're all out of anchovies over here. Do you want another topping instead? What? It's Joe's Pizzeria. You called 10 minutes ago. I talked to you, right?
Joe's Pizzeria?
Somebody called from this number and ordered 10 pizzas. Now I got 10 pizzas in the oven ready to go.
Oh, yeah, well, I'm just going to have to sell them. This ain't coming in.
It's going to be me. Look, I don't have time for this. Either somebody pays for these pizzas or I lose my job, you understand? You're not just going to let me lose my job, are you?
I'm not going to let you lose your job?
How am I going to pay my
job? No, I don't want you to lose your job. I don't want you to lose your job, but you ain't giving me, you ain't going to give me a doctor care. You ain't going to give me 10 pizzas that I didn't order either.
You know what? Fine. But just know, this is what I'm...
Hello?
Hey, I'm calling from Joe's Pizzeria. Look, we're all out of anchovies over here. Do you want another topping instead?
I'm sorry, you must have the wrong number.
Pizzeria. You called 10 minutes ago. I talked to you, right?
No, you didn't.
Well, somebody called from this number and ordered 10 pizzas. Now I got 10 pizzas in the oven ready to go.
Well, you didn't get it from this number.
Somebody's going to pay for these pizzas, and it ain't going to be me.
No, it isn't going to be me either.
I don't have time for this. Either somebody pays for these pizzas or I lose my job, you understand? You're not just going to let me lose my job, are you?
Look, you want to play a game, you can play the game. I'm telling you, nobody called from this house.
Come on, please, just pay for the pies.
Hello?
Hey, I'm calling from Joe's Pizzeria. Look, we're all out of anchovies over here. Do you want another topping instead? What? It's Joe's Pizzeria. You called 10 minutes ago. I talked to you, right?
Can you hold on 1 second, please?
Hold on
1 second.
Now I got 10 beaches in the oven ready.
Hold on, please, hold on.
Listen, somebody's going to pay for these beaches, and it ain't going to be me. Look, I don't have time for this. Somebody pays for these beaches, or I lose my job, you understand? You're not just going to let me lose my job, are you?
I didn't call for any pizza.
Oh, I'm not going to tell my wife I lost my job. I got 4 kids. I got bills. Come on, please. Just pay for the pies.
You're not fine. But who is this?
This is what I'm doing to all your pizzas.
Hello?
Hey, I'm calling from Joe's Pizzeria. Look, we're all out of anchovies over here. Do you want another topping instead?
You got the wrong number.
It's Joe's Pizzeria. You called 10 minutes ago. I talked to you, right?
No, you got the wrong number.
Somebody called from this number and ordered 10 pizzas. Now I got 10 pizzas in the oven ready to go.
I never called you. I don't even know who you are. Pizzas,
and it ain't going to be me.
I never called you. I don't even know who you are.
Either somebody pays for these pizzas or I lose my job.
Hello?
Hey, I'm calling from Joe's Pizzeria. Look, we're all out of anchovies over here. Do you want another topping instead?
I think you have the wrong number.
You called 10 minutes ago. I talked to you, right?
No.
Well, somebody called from this number and ordered 10 pizzas. Now I got 10 pizzas in the oven ready to go.
Well, that's not my problem, because I didn't order anything.
And it ain't going to be me. Look, I don't have time for this. Either somebody pays for these pizzas or I lose my job, you understand? You're not just going to let me lose my job, are you? Oh my God, I'm not going to tell my wife I lost my job. I got 4 kids, I got...
Listen, I got your number on my phone, so I'm going to call the police right now.
Hello? Hey, I'm from Joe's Pizzeria. Look, we're all out of anchovies over here. Do you want another topping instead? What? It's
Joe's
Pizzeria. You called 10 minutes ago. I talked to you, right?
I'm sorry.
Somebody called from this number and ordered 10 pizzas. Now I got 10 pizzas in the oven ready to go.
You really gotta be kidding me, right?
I'm gonna pay for these pizzas, and it ain't gonna be me. Look, I don't have time for this. Either somebody pays for these pizzas or I lose my job, you understand? You're not just going to let me lose my job, are you? Oh my God, how am I going to tell my wife I lost my job? I got 4 kids, I got bills. Come on, please, just pay for the pies.
I'll pay for the pies.
You know what? Fine. But just know, this is what I'm doing for all your pizzas.
Received a photogram.
Funny stuff there. You folks voted for it, and indeed, congratulations to my cousin Tony Scott for earning one of these little trophies here for the funniest moment on Live with Matt. It was kind of him and I put together, so I think I deserve one of these trophies too. But him and I together kind of decided, you know, we wanted to, you know, call a few people up, and we recorded it through fartogram.com. So it was some funny stuff that people fell for, I guess. And it, of course, you all liked it, so that was great. Our New Year surprise kiss, of course, you know, that was another one that everybody wanted to vote for. So that was second in the line there. Our next thing that I want to share with you, our next award that we're going to give out, is actually our favorite segment here on Live with Matt. So let's take a look at our favorite segment for our next video blog award. 3.5 years old, and she's got a little song that she sang, Take Me Out to the Ball Game.
Aww.
And when I first saw it, I thought, yeah, come on. Really, we're going to show this on here, but it was so cute.
So cute, I'm
yeah,
sure.
So we're going to show that to you right now. Coming up, my little cousin, Emily Heim, 3.5 years old, singing Take Me Out to the Ball Game. So let's take a look at it right now.
Out with the crowd,
buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jacks. I don't care if we ever get back in this room. Root, root for the Yankees. If they don't win, it's a shame. 'Cause it's 1, 2, 3 strikes, you're out at the old ball game.
So there you have it. Our favorite segment on Live with Matt was with little Emily here. And it's great to have little Emily. Hi, this is my probably the youngest guest I've ever had here on Live with Matt.
No.
Yes.
No.
And congratulations. This is yours. You can have it.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And now you did this. Now I said you were 3.5 years old. How old are you now?
Will this break?
No, I hope it doesn't break.
Does it break easily?
I hope not. I paid a lot of money for it. Those are the other people's awards that we're going to have in a moment here. How old are you now?
4.
You're 4 years old. Well, congratulations to Emily Heim. All of those people voted for you out there. You have anything to say to them?
No.
Maybe thank you?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, easy now. So congratulations to Emily. Now, everybody also, Emily, wants to know who our favorite co-host is going to be. You want to know who our favorite co-host is going to be?
No.
Guess the favorite answer is no around here. We're big surprise here with Matt. So let's take a look. Who is our favorite co-host here that you voted for on Live with Matt? Tuesday, October 16th, 2012.
Here. Thank you, Matt. It's nice to be here.
Tuesday, November 20th, 2012. And joining me on Live with Matt for the second time, Courtney Neer.
Thank you, Matt, for having me.
Welcome back. It's great to have you here. This is your second time on our video blog.
I feel honored to be the second guest.
First one back.
That's because you made
Tuesday, February 5th, 2013. She's back again. I don't know here. A lot of controversy with you.
I know.
2013 and making her return, Courtney Neer.
I am back.
Welcome back, Courtney.
Thank you.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
So the wine is young and fruity.
Oh, I do like a little bit. I like a little young.
Oh, wait a minute. Let's not get too involved here with that.
I do like it.
I was born on Thanksgiving morning.
Wow.
Yeah,
really?
So maybe that's why I like Thanksgiving so much.
Is your mom extra thankful for you?
I'm sure she is. Give me a break. Our next stop is Poughkeepsie. And next stop
you're one of those.
Oh, yes. I'm one of those. I was repeating the conductor and in his language also. You know, he had a little accent. So, of course, I always got to play with the accent.
Yeah.
So, finally, I didn't know what the next stop was. Hamburg was the
New
next
Hamburg.
Stop. New Hamburg.
New Hamburg.
Yeah. And all of a sudden, I said, well, next stop, there was no sound. And she chirped in, New Hamburg. I said, oh, well, I'm glad that you're participating with us. And then all of a sudden, she got to love us after that.
Oh, see? You're lovable. See? That's come on. You know, We're just having fun.
We just have to lighten up the situation. Yeah. It was a long train ride, lady.
You don't drink coffee, do you?
I have been, actually.
Really?
Yes, I went to drinking coffee. Can you imagine?
Oh, see, it happens.
I didn't drink coffee my whole 10 years of teaching. This year... Every morning.
Yep. Charles made me an addict.
Did he?
Yes. He gets coffee every morning when we used to commute together.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
I was like, every now and then,
as a treat, whatever. Right.
And now I'm hardcore.
Yeah.
I was noticing on one of your blogs that you mentioned Lotus Hair Salon.
Yes. Lotus Hair Design.
Design.
Let's get it right.
Design.
Here.
Sorry, and Chrissy.
Yes.
And so I wanted to say, too, that I got my hair done by her last week. And she did a fabulous job.
Looks beautiful.
Thank you. Yeah, she did a great. It's always a little scary going to a new person.
New,
and
yes.
But she did a great job. So.
Well, she used to experiment on me when she was in high school, you know, and that's probably why I don't have any hair in the back.
Here,
Live with Matt inbox. She called the Live with Matt and Courtney today. So
that's great.
Great to our other two co-hosts that
could
we
I
had.
Come again?
Absolutely.
Okay, good.
We'd love to have you back here once again.
Yeah. Up early and goes out on Black Friday.
Really? Oh, jeez.
So here are my tips. Number one.
Okay.
Have a plan,
because
you need to know what store you're going to, and you need to know what time, and you need to know what item you need to get.
Okay.
Because when you get in, it's kind of mass chaos.
Yeah, yeah.
In a fun way. So you have to have a plan, and you have to dress warm, because if you're out waiting in line, you know, it's cold.
Right.
I know the Black Friday app on your phone.
Oh,
which I have downloaded.
Well, of course, you know, come on. Of course you have to download that
app. Be patient. because you are going to be waiting in line, and there are going to be some people who are not always so nice are patient. So be patient and just kind of enjoy, you know.
Excellent.
There we
are. And I was by myself, and now look what we have.
And now love.
Oh, look at this. How could you resist this, people? You know, please.
Thank you for having me. And I hope I can come again.
We'd love to have you back. Love to have you back here to co-host with us.
You do have a following here.
I do have, I guess, yeah.
Yes, wow.
Yeah. Well, we have like a, you know, well, I think we have a
watch
connection.
Watch out here, Courtney. Sorry. Yes, we do.
Kick off your shoes. No soles on the bed, folks.
No
you know,
shoes
please.
On the bed.
What's wrong with these people?
I don't like socks in bed.
No?
No.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
I don't do socks in bed either.
No.
You know? We're not going there. Okay. Yeah, please. We don't want to know what Matt wears.
I
want to
read my fortune.
Oh, yes.
We had. I always like to read our fortune.
I do enjoy fortune, yeah.
Yeah, you like this. This
I do.
Fortune is. Would you like to read it for us? Go ahead and read it. You're taking over here.
I was just peeking.
Go ahead and read it, Kelly.
Ready?
Go ahead. Tell everybody what my fortune was.
Do your best to make it happen.
Congratulations, Courtney. Hopefully, I am proud to announce and very pleased to announce Courtney will be joining us next week here on Live with Matt. She's going to be our first co-host of our new season, really, joining me here at the table, joining us here on YouTube. So, Courtney, very nice job. I guess you do have a following out there. So we'll see you next week here on Live with Matt. Our final segment, and I think, you know, I deserve an award for that too, because I helped her be the favorite co-host, of course. But our final segment that I wanted to share with everybody is actually my good friend. We've been talking about her for the whole season of Live with Matt. This is actually how it started, because I sent in a little audition video clip to join Kelly down in New York City. So Kelly, my good friend, Kelly Ripa, here she is. Kelly, it's Matt, the one you've been waiting to co-host with. Even my students wanted me to co-host with you. One of them drew a nice picture of me and you walking out on stage together. I'm on summer vacation and would love to spend the morning with you. I'm ready, so
be doing because I wanted to be co-hosting with Kelly down in New York City. Now that didn't happen. Just as a co-host for the day. I'm not quitting my day job, of course. Just for her.
I know you wanted that. You know, shame on.
For her guest co-host, come on, Kelly. You know, give me a break here.
Kelly, give the guy a chance.
Yeah. So, but
maybe
it turned out to be a joke. But now we've got this whole thing live with Matt every Tuesday night. So, we're here just for entertainment, of course. So
I don't know. My good friend Kelly Ripa. I still watch Kelly and Michael. My good friend Kelly Ripa said it's good because everyone is always so tired after the meal, it gets you out and moving.
That's right. That's right. It's good and it's fun. It kind of gets you in the spirit, I think, and gets you in the mood and, you know.
Hopefully you'll get some good deals this
very
soon. And hopefully we're going to find out from our friend Kelly. Can you imagine here?
Can you imagine Kelly sitting here?
Oh, I would love it.
I know. She'd be on here every week.
I'd go down to her. She wouldn't even have to come here. We take the show on the road, as we like to call it.
My friend Kelly.
Oh, here. No, Kelly.
Yes, yes.
You know, my friend. My good friend, she had mentioned on her show that she doesn't eat chicken wings at all.
Ever? No.
Ever.
Well, she's so tiny, she probably doesn't.
She's never tried one.
Never even tried one.
No. She said there's really no chicken on that list.
It's true. So I agree.
No, Maria is in. But my friend Chrissy wants to remain in the background just doing my hair. So I guess I don't think we're going to see Chrissy for a while.
I need some new color.
Oh, you think so? Don't tell her that, please. That's all I have to hear. But let me tell you something. Michael Strahan, you know, I always like my friend Kelly.
Right.
I still watch him. But Michael Strahan gets his hair cut twice a week. Did you hear that, Chrissy? Twice a week, Michael Strahan gets his hair cut.
That was a good one.
So, Kelly and Michael's show, you know, my friend Kelly Ripa.
I always have to admit. Fun down
I love Kelly Ripa. You know, I tried to get tickets for their show, but of course, you know, they were in Florida. I couldn't go all the way down.
Right.
So hopefully during our April vacation.
That'll be great.
But they had their big Oscar special yesterday, so that was great. I got my ticket in the mail here to go back to see Live with Kelly and Michael, but of course, they send it for me when I'm back in school. I'm not going to pull that again and try to get that out. Please, we've got all kinds of problems. But this was for the 10th of April. I put back in to see if we can get back in next week, but we'll see what happens.
Do they have a standby?
They do have a standby, yeah, but I'm not going to, you know, I'm not going to take a chance. You know, it's hard to get in there. So we'll see what happens. I put in for it again. Maybe next week if I but I'm gonna hopefully get down to see my girlfriend Kelly, so
yes,
we'll see what happens.
That
yeah, I hope so. But I had posted on our page about that my guest co-host was gonna be my friend Kelly Ripa. So of course everybody, you know, liked that, and of course our friend Wendy had a comment. And she said that cardboard cutouts don't count. That's a good idea though, Wendy. I might look for a cardboard cutout of Kelly Ripa. That'd be great. We'll have her here in the back. My friend Kelly Ripa called him up, and he was the special celebrity correspondent on the show.
Oh.
What about me?
Yeah.
I'm sitting here every week.
Well, maybe you guys dropped the
I guess
bomb.
So. I guess so. Well, I think we did, but, you know, we come on. Man. It's hard to look right at your
baby, but here's my number. Now, you didn't think Kelly Ripa actually came here, I'm sure. I wish. Maybe one day I'll go down and see Kelly here, or maybe she'll join me here at the co-host desk. That would be wonderful, wouldn't it be? But anyway, I'm glad that you tuned in. Thank you, all of our viewers, for tuning in each and every week here on YouTube. We're going to keep it going every Tuesday at 8:30. Next week, joining me as a special guest co-host, Courtney Neer makes her return. And also, we're going to open up the live with Matt Inbox. So send in your questions and comments that we'll read on the video blog next week. Have a great week, everybody.